This is Trent Reznor. He's the founder and frontman of Nine Inch Nails. In addition to being a rock star, he and his composing partner, Atticus Ross, have become one of the most distinct voices in film scoring. While Ross began composing films before teaming up, Reznor was no stranger to cinema. The music of Nine Inch Nails is often ambient while also being dark and harsh and transgressive. Which makes it a perfect match for this guy. Before appearing on Twin Peaks, Trent Reznor, who is a huge fan of David Lynch, was approached by the director to lend his sound to Lost Highway. While Reznor wasn't asked to score Lost Highway, Lynch wanted him to produce some tracks in order to enhance the soundscape of the film. He gave Reznor the following direction. There's a box, okay? And in this box, there's snakes coming out. Snakes whizzing past your face. Somehow, that led to this. But Reznor and Ross's first collaborative project was scoring David Fincher's The Social Network, which won them an Academy Award. The score is not like that of conventional composing. There is no orchestra, there is nothing lavish or sweeping. The score is electronic-like. It's cold and distant and uninviting, which mirrors the nature of the main character. Reznor remembers one of the biggest challenges being that The Social Network is jam-packed with Aaron Sorkin's dialogue. How do you compose around something like that? Well, take a listen to this scene.
I'm not sure why you're asking me that.
It's not important. You'd be sure why I'm asking.
It's not important to you.
Si, did you know that they came for money?
I had no idea whether they came for money or not.
The music is there, but it doesn't call attention to itself. It simply pulses under the dialogue, creating a distinct moodiness. We may not even realize that the music is there, but we surely feel its impact. For comparison's sake, let's look at another film written by Sorkin, but with a different composer and a more traditional score.
I was the only thing protecting it!
You didn't want the ad because you were trying to kill the Mac 2 months before it launched!
You are f***ing delusional!
The music here is grand and attention-grabbing. We know it's there and we are aware of its function. It's enhancing the drama of the confrontation. Now let's look at a confrontational scene from The Social Network.
You better lawyer up, asshole, because I'm not coming back for 30%. I'm coming back for everything.
There is no right versus wrong here, but the approach of Reznor and Ross is much more subtle. The music is creating tension, but we hardly even notice it. This non-traditional approach to composing has followed Reznor and Ross throughout their body of work. Like The Social Network, in Fincher's The Girl with the Dragon Tattoo, Reznor and Ross often remain unnoticed, creating subconscious tension.
When I'm looking at this, not to mention the way you're looking at me now, I don't think you have.
Let's drop the dialogue out of this scene and continue with just the music. Notice how the music all by itself creates tension and communicates the inner turmoil of Lisbeth. With Gone Girl, Fincher explained that he wanted the score to be an insincere facade, something that inauthentically tries to make you feel okay. Listen to how the music in this scene seems comforting at first, and then Reznor and Ross slowly begin to introduce conflicting tones.
All right, you can stop pretending now.
I'm not pretending. You are perfect. The Nick I saw on TV, that's the Nick I fell in love with.
You do know I was just telling you what you wanted to hear.
As the scene progresses, the dissident tones begin to overpower the comforting tones, signifying that things are not going to be resolved. Reznor and Ross are surely best known for their work with David Fincher. Scoring his last three films, the duo is a crucial element to Fincher's specific style and tone. To date, the only non-Fincher film they have worked on is Peter Berg's Patriots Day. Despite being a far cry from the work of David Fincher, Reznor and Ross still maintain their signature sound, proving that these musicians have a style that is distinctively their own. And with only four films under their belt, they are just getting started.